In this Raspberry Pi Pico small core lesson, we are going to explain the expansion board. Welcome to Raspberry Pi Pico small core course by RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri and I will be your instructor for this course. This course is based on Sun Founder's Raspberry Pi Pico four-wheel drive car kit. Besides this 10-lesson course, the kit has full documentations, step-by-step instructions, wiring diagrams, Python codes, and example projects available for download. The car can be controlled using mobile app for mobile or tablet, where you can control the car fully forward, backward, turn right, turn left, and also you can turn on and off the light, you can set the power of the motors, you can see the speed in meter per second. You can see the radar obstacle avoidance data where the obstacle is. Also, you can see the line tracking or a halo deep sensor data. It can track a line or follow the line. It has cliff detector and it can follow your hand and it can avoid obstacle and drive. The kit is available for purchase on Sun Founder and major online stores. The link to purchase the kit is below this video. This is our main expansion board, which holds this Raspberry Pi Pico board. And it has a lot of other components, which makes our car function. If you come to the Sun Founder documentation page, under the appendix, you will see a schematic and a structure drawing. We can see the schematic and drawing. And if we click on a Pico RDP, this is the schematic for expansion board. We have ESP12S chip. This is the Wi-Fi module that used with app to control the car. This is the Wi-Fi module. And then we have here TC1508S. Two of this is used to control the motor. Here, two of them. Here, you see that 1508F that is closer to these motor connectors. This is the main socket where the Pico will be inserted to these pins. And here we have one pin for 3.3 volts. And this is the switch. These are all the other terminals that we have connected to this. And these are available for us. When we connect the power terminal, it goes to this pin and there is a fuse. And after that, we have the power out. This is the MOSFET switch, which connects the ground. AT205. Here, this is the 8205 MOSFET switch, located closer to this power output terminal. And then we have this chip. This is a converter where we will get input voltage. This is a step-down converter where we will get around 7.4 volts and we will always have 5 volts at the output. Here, this is an inductor, 6.8 microhenry, which refers to this 6.8 8 microhenry inductor. This is the chip. And from 5 volts, this 5 volts is coming to this point, and it goes through this regulator where we have 3.3 volts output from this AMS1117. And here is the AMS1117, 3.3 volts, which is located in here under the chip in this area. LM393, this is connected to this yellow LED. It's driving this yellow LED, and also we have another yellow LED. Let's pay attention to these pins. These are for receive, these are 3.3 volts and RX, TX, if you want to connect it from outside. And then these are analog to digital converter pins, pin 26, 27. And so the black is ground, these three pins. These are all 3.3 volts, including this portion, pin 6, 7, 8, and 9. So anywhere you need 3.3 volts, you can get, doesn't matter where you connect it. So red is positive, ground. And these are the pins, pin 6, pin 7, 8, and 9, yellow. As you can see, 26, 27, 28. Pin 10, 11, 12, 13, these have been connected. These are for signals. Pin, each pin, the yellow is a pin number beside it, but the middle pin is all 5 volts, and this is all ground. And the same way, 16, 15, 14, also these are 5 volts. These are 5 volts from 18 to 21. I've shown you under the magnifier, but let's have a look at it again here. This is a power switch, and then we have a MOSFET switch that is controlling the connecting to the ground. And this is a step-down converter, which gives 7.2 volts or to 8.4 volts initially when it's charged. So we get always 5 volts from this. 5 volts from this comes here, and we will get 3.3 volts as well. So the 5 volt is available for our these two motor drivers. These are the motor driver chips which are controlling the motor. This chip is used for two motors. This is also for two motors. This is ESP12S. That is a Wi-Fi module based on ESP8266, where you can connect to the Wi-Fi and to the internet to communicate. Our app is communicating using this chip. Underneath of this, here we have LM393 that is driving these two LEDs for us. Recess switch, this is special terminal of I2C that for other modules that might be available, it will be connected, but in this course we are not using it. This is for UART USB communication. If you want to program this device, because they have already done it for you, you don't worry about it, either from USB or from this one. These are all, the blacks are all ground, and on this side, these reds are 3.3 volts, and these reds are 5 volts. So if you sometimes forget about it, think this way. These chips are for the motor, these are 5 volts, and these 5 volts are closer to this. So these are all 5 volts, and these are 3.3 volts. And the other pins are each labeled, so we can access the pins of this module. Now let's see how we can develop codes and Sony, the Python code. You can send it directly from your computer, or you can leave it on this. The code that you send from your computer will work only when you click run on the device itself. On the right side, if I click, this is my COM port. It shows MicroPython, Raspberry Pi Pico, COM 12. In your case, it might be different. When I click, now it gets connected, and you will see the files that exist on this in here. Now, if I want to run any of the codes that we have here, if I go to this and let's say for the test, this RGB, and if I click run, now any code that I open here on the screen that you see, this code, if I run it, it will run on this by clicking on this button. But If you want to run a code, and when you disconnect it, you want it, and if you want the code to exist on the board, and when you disconnect the cable, then you must transfer the code to your board inside the file called main. Here I have a main.py. I can double click and open it here. Don't worry what is inside it. So I put the video like this, so every time I can refer to this. So even if the main does not exist, let me right click and delete it. Here, I'm just selecting yes. So the main have been deleted from this. I can create from this example, let's say you want to get this app control. This one, I'm just right clicking and selecting it all. When it is selected, right click, copy, then go on file, create new, and then right click, paste. Now that's the code. Let's now save it to the device. If I click file and save, you see this screen is asking you where you want to save it. Let's select Raspberry Pi Pico. When I select it, it pops up and it shows all the files. I can select to replace any of those, or if you want, because we are creating a new main.py, make sure to put .py and then click OK. Now I got error because we were running the code. And after that, let's click File and Save. From this screen that pops up, select Raspberry Pi, and it will ask you to enter the name. I'm typing here main.py. Make sure you put .py. When I click and save, you will see that the file is created here. Now the file is here. If I disconnect it and restart this or turn it on, the code that we have on the main will run. So keep that in mind. But it's very easy. At any time, you can just test any code that you have. For example, this is about Blink, and as I've explained it before. So for this, we can just click and run, and it will start running. You see, it's blinking. Now, if I disconnect it, the code doesn't exist on this, because the code just sent instruction to run it, but it does not reside on the board. Thank you for watching a Raspberry Pi Pico lesson from RoboJax. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and thumb up the video. You can wait a few seconds. The next lesson will start automatically, or click on the link to proceed now.